Next topic is the relationship between the line voltage and phase voltage for this delta connection. So, you know, the line voltages are VRY, BYB and BBR, and the phase voltages are the voltage across the phases. So those are ERN, EYN and EBN. And since all are the AC quantity, so to represent AC quantity, I kept a small bar over there. So that shows these are the AC quantity. Of course, there is nothing, no need to say, all are AC quantities. So once again, what we have to do, we have to find this VRY. There is a little thing, if you will hear, let's say this is point R, let's say this is point A, this is point B, and this is point C, if we will define. And if we apply Kirchhoff's voltage law in this loop, there are three loops possible. So one is this loop, which will connect this one. The second one is this one, second loop. And to relate BBR with this one, we will take this complete bigger one loop. So there are three loops. In these three loops, we will apply Kirchhoff's voltage law. So likhenge applying KVL. Applying KVL in mesh or loop, whatever you say, come in. Mesh. The mesh is RAB, RAB, YR. RAB, YR. So, if we will apply in this one, then what would be the result? Here it will be, if we are saying this is plus and this way, so B R Y bar will become simply equals to E Y N. And there is no other voltage in this loop, so of course these two will be the... And of course, if this is the arrow, it means this is plus, this is minus. And if we are considering BRY, voltage of line R with respect to the Y, so this is plus minus. Similarly, when we will apply KVL in mesh, similarly applying KVL in mesh, YBC, and again B. So these two point, you may get confused, same having same rotation. So let's say this is your B dash. So if this one is your B dash, so in this case this one is B dash, and in this case YB dash, CBY. So this one is the loop. And once we will apply in this loop, so if we are saying BYB, it means this is positive, this one is negative. It means the voltage of line Y with respect to the line B. And if we are representing this kind of arrow, it means this is your plus sign and this is your minus. So once again we will write, so we will have equation of BYB equals to EBN. And also the next one we will apply, then it will be BBR, that is equals to ERN. So we will write here, so for balanced three phase system, we must have mod of ERN equals to mod of EYN, that is equals to mod of EBN, and this one is your all are the phase voltages, so we will represent it by BP, not EP. Let's say this is your BP. It means the magnitude of VRY equals to mod of BYB, and this is equals to mod of BBR. This is equals to, all will be equal and that is equals to BP, and all will be collectively represented by BL. So therefore, VL equals to BP. In case of delta connected system. In case of delta connected system, this VL will become equals to BP. So next thing is the relationship between IL and IP. So to find the relationship between the IL and IP, so the line currents will be IL1, let's say this is IL2, and this one is your IL3, and the current that we will represent here, it will be IR, IY and IB. We will apply KCL at this point A. So KCL at A. So we will apply KCL at A. What would be the value of I? Of course, all are the AC quantities, so we will keep bar sign over there. So what would be the IL1? IR is coming, IY is going in this direction, remaining is here. So IL1 will be equals to IR minus IY. या फिर अगर मैं algebraic sum ले लूँ यहाँ पे, algebraic sum of incoming and outgoing, तो incoming is IR, outgoings are IY and IL1, so the equation will be IR minus IY minus IL1. So in this we have, we will write IL1 equals to IR minus IY. And similarly, when we will go for KCL at B dash and C, KCL at B dash, so you will get IL2. KCL at B dash, IL2, algebraic sum lenge, to incoming current is IY, while IL2 and IB both are outgoing current. So expression may be written as IY minus IB minus IL2 equals to 0. So IL2 will become equals to IY minus IB. And at C, at this point, this is your IL3. This one is IL3, so IL3 may be written as, this is IB minus IR. Since we have to perform the subtraction of two AC quantities, IR, IY and IB, so we will have to draw phasor diagram of IR, IY and IB, and then based on these expressions we will find the phasor diagram of IL1, IL2 and IL3. So once again we will draw the phasor diagram of IR. Ab yahan pe ek badi important baat hai samajhne wali. You know, this is a three phase balance system means the magnitude of the voltage across phase R, across phase Y and across phase B will be same. Magnitude will be same, but they will differ in their phase angles. IR will have 0 degree, IY will have minus 120 and this will have minus 240 or plus 120. Whatever is comfortable, you may use both. And also the magnitude of the current across three phases will also be the same. So mod of IR, mod of IY and mod of IB will be the same. But there is a possibility that there would be some phase angle difference between this ER and IR based on this load. If this is a RLC circuit, so it may be leading, it may be lagging, kuch bhi ho sakta hai. So of course, based on this circuit element, ek general baat karein, so based on circuit element, there would be some phase angle difference between this voltage and this current. correct? So most of the time, 99% loads are of inductive nature. Inductive nature means very rarely you will find load is having capacitive nature. So since it is inductive, so therefore we will go with the majority, and we will consider, since most of the loads are inductive nature, so we will consider that this current is lagging behind this voltage by some angle phi, correct? Because of the inductive current, of course, will lag behind. And if the current will lag behind, it means we will consider that the phase angle difference between this voltage and this current is some phi. Now you know these three voltages, ERN, EYN and EBN, are 120 degree apart. So of course, if we will represent in this way, let's say this is your ERN, this one is EYN, and this one is EBN. So all three are, these angles are 120 degree, 120 degree, 120 degree. And we are also considering that this current is lagging behind this voltage by some angle phi. So it means if we will show the phasor diagram of IR, so this IR will be somewhere here with this angle as a phi. Similarly, if we have to show a current which is lagging behind this, so it means this current will be somewhere here with the same angle phi, because the system is balanced. System is balanced means whatever is the kind of the load is here, the same kind of the load is here, same kind of the load is here, because the system is balanced, right? So the same phase angle difference for IY will be here, and the same kind of the phase angle difference you will find IB for IB here. And if this is phi, this is phi, this angle will also be the phi. And once we draw this phasor diagram of IR, IY and IB, the next target is to draw the phasor diagram for IL1. And IL1 is your IR minus IY. It means if we have the phasor diagram of IY, we will reverse that phasor diagram, and then we will connect with IR, and then we will reach to IL1. So this one is your IY. So since this needs to be subtracted, so we will draw opposite of it. We will draw a line, and we will say this is your minus IY. All are AC quantities, so there will be bar. So this is your minus IY. But the magnitude, if the magnitude of this IR, this IY and this IB are some IPs, then this magnitude of this will also be some IP. The only difference will be the phase angle difference. It will differ in phase angle. So the, now the resultant of this IR and IY will give you IL1. So therefore, by using a parallelogram method of addition, we will use, and this will give us IL1. एक पॉइंट ऑफ ऑब्जर्वेशन है, दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. इफ दिस एंगल इज फाइ, दिस एंगल इज ऑल्सो फाइव, वॉट अबाउट दिस एंगल? 120. भाई अगर दो, यू नो दिस एंगल इज 120, दिस इज लैगिंग बिहाइंड बाय फाइ, एंड दिस वन इज ऑल्सो लैगिंग बिहाइंड बाय द सेम एंगल फाइ. इट मीन्स ये स्लाइटली शिफ्ट हो गए. So the angle between this IR and IY will be 120. Similarly, the angle between this IR and IB will be 120. And the angle between IB and IR will again be 120 degree. Yeh samajh mein aaya? Iska matlab hai ki if the three, in case of the three phase system, if the voltage or phase voltages are 120 degree apart, then phase currents will also be 120 degree apart, provided condition is system is balanced. If the system is unbalanced, you cannot define, you cannot say anything. Samajh mein aapko? So all these conditions are valid only for balanced system. And once this one is okay, then we obtained this phasor diagram of IL1. And similarly, we can also obtain, draw the phasor diagram for IL2 also. And IL2 is what? Your IY minus IB. So this one is IB. So this is minus IB. And then we will draw parallelogram method of addition we are using. And finally, this is the phasor diagram of IL2. And last, I3. I3 is your IB minus IR. This one is IB and this is your IR. So opposite of it. So this is your minus IR. and then parallelogram method of addition. This is your IL3. Now, अगर एंगल के बारे में बात करें, so if this angle is 120 degree, what about this angle? 60, of course, as we did last case, so this one is 60 degree. Similarly, this angle is also 60 degree, and this angle is also 60 degree. And you know, the system is well balanced, so it means the magnitudes will be equal. So it means IL1 is the resultant of two equal magnitudes. So of course it will be the bisector of this one. So it means this angle is 30 degree, this angle is also 30 degree. And one more interesting observation is, if this is okay, can you tell me what would be this angle? Angle between IL1 and IL2. It will be 120. कितने लोगों को 120 दिख गया ये? जिन लोगों को नहीं दिख रहा वो कंफर्टेबली ड्रॉ कर लें और उसको आराम से ड्रॉ करके देखिएगा, ऑब्जर्व करके, बिकॉज समटाइम्स वी नीड टू वेरीफाई द थिंग्स एज पर आवर फेथ सिस्टम, कि हमारे पास जो इन्फॉर्मेशन, हमारे पास जो नॉलेज है, उसके हिसाब से क्या बैठ रहा है. तो यू प्लीज मेक श्योर, अगर किसी को डाउट होगा देन वी विल डिस्कस अगेन. And then angle between the IL2 and this IL3 is again 120, and this one is again 120. Iska matlab ye hai ki line currents are also 120 degree apart if the system is balanced. Samajh mein aapko? In fact, if this system had not been balanced, probably it is one of the most typical and a very complex topic. Samajh mein aapko? And basically because of the balance, being system balanced, it has removed many of the complexities. Samajh mein aapko? So it is very simple because we are considering only the balance system. And fortunately, balance system is only in our syllabus. We do not have to deal with the unbalanced system. So now you know, we have IL1 is the resultant of two quantities, IR and minus IY, with the angle difference between them as 60 degree. The angle between these two is 60 degrees. So we will use the same formula as we did in last class. The resultant of two vectors A and B with angle theta between them, the magnitude of the resultant would be under root of mod of A square mod of B square plus 2 times mod of A mod of B cos of theta. So based on that we will again write, so therefore mod of IL1 mod of IL1 will be equals to under root mod of IR square plus mod of minus IY square plus 2 times mod of IR into minus IY into cos of angle between them is 60 degree. So as we know, for balanced system, for balanced three-phase system, mod of IR equals to mod of IY equals to mod of IB, that is, let's say that is equals to IP. So if this is IP, so mod of IL1 can be written as under root of IP square plus IP square, this is mod, plus 2 times IP square into cos 60 is 1/2. So this is equals to under root 3 IP square, and that is equals to root 3 times of IP. So this is mod of IL1. And similarly, we can write for IL2 and IL3. So we will write here similarly, mod of IL2 will be equal to root 3 times of IP, and mod of IL3 equals to root 3 times of IP, because all have 60 degree phase angle difference between the those two quantities which needs resultant. So mod of IL1, mod of IL2, mod of IL3 all are equal. So based on this we will write here mod of IL1 equals to mod of IL2 equals to mod of IL3 equals to root 3 times of IP, and we will call it as a this mod as a IL. So IL equals to root 3 times of IP is okay. So now next one is the power expression. So three phase power, P three phase will be what? 3 times of BP IP cos of phi. In case of delta connection, BP is your VL and IP is IL by root 3, and this is cos phi. So the final expression is root 3 VL IL cos phi. So this is total three phase power. So the formula of the three phase power is same in case of whether it is the system is star connected or delta connected, but there is a difference in the relationship of line voltage, phase voltage, line current and phase current. In case of a star connected system, VL equals to root 3 times of BP and IL equals to IP in a star, while in delta VL equals to BP but IL equals to root 3 times of IP. And these two derivations are very important.